If you're on a low budget, investing or just making your money back in CSGO may seem like a bit of a challenge. So today I'm going to cover some options on how to make money by just playing CSGO and how practically anybody can do it. But before we get into it, if you are in the 91% of people that watch my videos and aren't subscribed to the channel, please do be sure to click that subscribe button. It does help me out a lot, and you've probably watched my videos before and just aren't subscribed, so it wouldn't mean a lot to me if you did. And every time I mention this, I seem to get a lot more subscribers, so it is working. So please do subscribe if you do want to keep up with some investing news and just CSGO in general. I would greatly appreciate it, and it would really help a homie out. We are on the road to 16k now, so be sure to subscribe. But for now, let's get right into the video. So first, I want to talk a bit more about Operation Stars and exactly how much money you can make if you bought the Operation Pass, because it's honestly probably more than you thought. It is a lot of money. So I covered this in one of my other videos, but as I'm sure you guys know by now, you can get a total of 100 Operation Stars throughout the entire 16-week operation. If you go into the item shop, the broken fan case only costs 2 stars, so you can get a total of 50 Operation Broken Fan Cases if you invest all of your stars into them. And rather than putting your stars into some random collection and probably just getting a garbage skin out of it, you're practically guaranteed your money back by putting all your stars into broken fan cases, as they're currently selling for around $1 each on Steam. But not only are they currently selling for $1 each on Steam, they have been since the beginning of the operation pretty much, even with many more coming into circulation. So let's assume you get all your cases, 50 of them total, and sell them as soon as you get them for 98 cents each on the market, which is what they're currently going for. Take out Steam tax and you'll get 86 cents per case. If we multiply that by 50, once again, for the max total number of cases you can get throughout the operation, that's a solid $43. Now, that is a really good price considering the Operation Pass only costs $15, and just putting all your stars to cases can practically triple the money you put in. So if you're smart with your Operation Stars, you're gonna get some really solid money back. In fact, the $43 you would have in your Steam wallet after selling all the cases would actually only put you $20 away from the cheapest CSGO knife on the Steam market. So you would only pay $15 for the Battle Pass, spend a few hours a week grinding out like 3 missions to get the max stars for the week, get your cases, sell them, and potentially pick yourself up a really nice skin or reinvest the money into other items or whatever you might do. Tripling your money in general in such a short period of time isn't bad at all. So you could make a bit more money if you invest and want to watch my other videos on investing networks, or you could just stay safe with your $43 or something around that amount. Either way, you're making some money. But keep in mind, this is if the cases retain their $1 value throughout the entire operation. But even if they drop to something like 50 cents, once again they're currently 98 cents on the Steam market, that's still 50 cents times 50 cases, which is a cool $25, which is still 10 more than you paid for the Operation Battle Pass. And I definitely don't see them dropping that low in price. So if you're solely out to get some funds in your Steam wallet, simply just buy cases and sell them right away. It's the safest and quickest money back guarantee, and you could have some more money for skins, games, whatever it may be. But another thing I want to talk about in this video is abusing new drops or operation items that are in the game. If you literally have no budget, this is a great way to get some Steam wallet funds, but it partially requires some luck in some cases. The first way you can do this requires a new operation, so it might be a minute to say the least, but it's always good to be prepared. Pretty much all you have to do is either have some funds in your Steam wallet to buy something sought after like stickers right after they come out, and I mean right after. For example, the Battle Scarred Hollow from Operation Broken Fang was going for under $2 during the first day of the operation, and now is practically double that and consistent on the Steam market, so bulking up on those while they're cheap, whether to resell them literally the next day for profit or just hold on to them as an investment, is another solid move. Grinding out your operation missions the first day to put your stars into cases, assuming the next operation has an item shop as well, is another good idea too, as operation generation broken fan cases, for example, sell for like 70 cents more the first day than they do the second day on the Steam market. And I know a lot of you guys watching this don't have too much money to invest with, so it's always nice just to have some extra Steam wallet funds for games, skins, or whatever it may be. And if you have the option to play the operation on the first day, that's some easy money you could put in your pocket as well. But the final thing you can really do to get the most out of Steam wallet funds by not spending too much money, in fact, not spending any money at all, is just grinding out deathmatches or casual matches when a new case drops, and selling that case shortly after they drop. Unfortunately, getting case drops in the game is kinda random, and so is CSGO's release date on new cases, but if we look at something like the Clutch case, this thing was selling for like $8 on the first day it was out. So if you ever see a new case come out, grinding out deathmatch can be a pretty profitable move if you get lucky and happen to get dropped a case the day it comes out, or within the first week, you're still making good money. But keep in mind, your drops per week in CSGO are limited. I believe you can only get a max of like 4 drops per week, so it may be kinda hard to keep track of. And if you have an alt account, grinding out on that in deathmatch just to try and get the new case drop and sell it for a few extra bucks is really the best way to get money in your Steam wallet without actually putting any money in the game or going on sketchy gambling sites, using somebody's affiliate code and hoping you get rich quick. This is pretty much the only legitimate way to make money on Steam, or in CSGO I guess, without putting any of your money in. But yeah, besides that, I think that does pretty much wrap it up for this video, covering some easy ways to profit without having to put in too much money, if any at all, into CSGO. So be sure to subscribe to the channel if you're new, and check out some of my other investing content if you have a few bucks to play with. But for now, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.